So we will just we calculate our force like this. So we have values of A dash here. We are just plugging this A dash value. We are just taking the component of phi rho component of A dash from our equation, and here we are just plugging the phi component and rho component of A dash to the force equation. So our force is actually this. So yeah, so this is the equation for the force, and where A dash is like to be this. So actually this is not a complete solution, because for this integration you have to do a lot of time. So I didn't do this calculation. So if you can just calculate back to the value of phi command and rho command of A dash to F, and you can just see what's the value of F, because this integration is very low. So we will go to the first steps. You can just plug those terms to this force equation. So your force equation is like to this. So this is the limiting value of the force. When if you are considering A is D is very very less than D. So A is very very less than D. So this is the limiting value of force. So we express the limiting value of force in terms of permeability of this free space and permeability of the medium. So this permeability is contributed by the metallic slab, and mu zero is the permeability of the medium, and I is subtracting flow into the loop. So you can see that F has a dependence on I square, although it has a dependence on A divided by D, where D is the distance between the loop and the semi-intrinsic slab. So they also asked, is it possible to get the same solution with any other method? So you can just get the same answer by using this relation, like F is equal to gradient of m dot b of 0. So for the second case, we can use the same approach, like we calculate our A dash is like to be this, and we use the tail expansion for the denominator terms. So after using the tail expansion, we will get the denominator there, 1 divided by rho by d cos phi is like to be this. So we have got the higher order terms in the term expansion. So after the expansion, we are just plugging these values into the integral. So your A dash is will change like to be this after doing the tail expansion. Then we have just plugged all those terms of A phi A rho from this equation to F. So for that thing you have to do lot of algebra. After doing that, you will get the same solution as above the semi-infinity star. So that configuration is exactly same as by putting two MAC 90 degrees. The second part of the problem is we are just placing the loop perpendicular to the semi-infinity star. That configuration is exactly same as by placing two magnetic 90 degrees. So you can just see that here the direction of the field is from here to here, and this is from here to here. You can just see the loop, the direction of the loop. So conceptually, these two figures are exactly same as our problem. So you can just get an idea. You can just get an idea.